What's up, guys? This is Manoj Pani. I welcome you all on behalf of the ADPDO world. It's been a fantastic morning outside, and I'm sure that you guys must be enjoying your life to the fullest, guys. Certainly, you are. So, how's your preparation going on with the remaining subjects? How's your preparation going on with SFM? Is it going good? Wonderful, guys. So, this is gonna be the seventh video presentation in which I'm gonna discuss with you the remaining questions which have already been asked with respect to the topic of derivatives. This is gonna be the final video of this particular chapter. By now, I am hoping that certainly you guys have revised your topics completely, and surely you're thorough with the concepts, whatever the kind of things that institute expects out of you guys. I have made you understand each one of that particular thing. So I just hope that you are retaining your topics time and again, because that is something which is extremely imperative for each one of you. Don't skip on that, guys. Remember it. So let's mark the beginning of this particular presentation, which is gonna be the final conclusion of derivatives. And I hope you guys are gonna be liking it like anything. So the first question of the day will be, this question was asked in CII final examination for May 2012. It says, a company is long on 10 metric ton of copper at the rate of rupees 474 per kg. That is something which is being provided to us as a spot price. And the company intends to remain so for the ensuing quarter as well. The standard deviation of changes of its spot and future prices are 4% and 6% respectively. They're having a correlation coefficient of 0.75. We are expected to provide them the hedge ratio. What is the hedge ratio in this particular question? Along with that, the question is also asking us to provide a solution for what should be the amount of copper future it should basically short to achieve a perfect hedge. These are the two different questions which are incorporated in this one single question which was asked in CII final examination for May 2012. So what do I mean by hedge ratio, guys? Before heading towards the solution parts, before knowing what is all about the question, let's first understand the basic of what do I mean by hedge ratio. Remember one thing, which is hedge ratio is nothing but a kind of beta. Okay, why I say this that it's a beta? Because hedge ratio is something which will be different for one company to another company. It's not going to be the same for each company or various diverse companies who are available in the market. So one company's stock might be riskier than another company's stock. There is a positioning in the market wherein we can say that nowadays pharmaceutical companies are more prone to towards risk than the let's say aviation industry. So what do I mean by this thing? I simply mean that perfect beta for that particular pharmaceutical company is gonna be a bit bigger and higher than as compared to aviation industry. So by simply saying and quoting that one thing, I can tell you that since I'm telling you that the beta of one industry is riskier than another industry, so in order to hedge your position in pharmaceutical industry, you need to have something different from what you are expecting to provide if in case you are hedging your position in aviation industry. So hedge ratio is going to be different. You need to protect your assets accordingly as per the company's beta. So there you need to hedge accordingly. So your hedge ratio is going to be changing with respect to your beta. So this is what hedge ratio is perfectly all about. It is nothing but beta, and it is basically defined with a particular concept which it says the correlation coefficient between the market, okay, and your company, that has to be multiplied with your standard deviation of your today's spot price. Okay, what is your risk at today's date? Divide the same with your standard deviation of your future price. What is expected to be occurring in your case after a certain point of time? And that is what this particular hedge ratio is all about. It says hedge ratio is equivalent to your correlation coefficient multiplied by your standard deviation of your spot price divided with your standard deviation of your future price. And this is what hedge ratio is all about. Now, in this particular scenario, we can simply say that why am I doing this? I mean, let's make you understand another one thing, which is why am I multiplying your standard deviation of spot with your correlation coefficient and not standard deviation of future price with correlation coefficient and vice versa? Why am I not doing it? Remember, guys, hedging is something which is gonna be occurring for your future. Okay, you don't hedge your position for your current date. You basically do it in the present in order to take care of your future. Okay, so whatever the kind of correlation coefficient is between you and the market, okay, that has to be multiplied with your spot standard deviation, and it has to be divided by your standard deviation of future only. Only then you will come to a conclusion of having the most accurate and most reliable hedge ratio. And that is why it is being correlation coefficient is actually multiplied with the spot standard deviation and not with the future standard deviation. That is the only reason, because you are doing it for your future, so you need to divide it with your standard deviation of your future. Hedge ratio in this particular scenario, it's gonna be 0.5. How do I came to a conclusion that it's gonna be a 0.5? I just multiplied my correlation coefficient, which is 0.75, with the standard deviation of spot, which is 4%. So I come to the numerator part as 0.75 multiplied by 4, it comes out to be 3. Divide the same with your standard deviation of your future, which is 6%. 3 divided by 6, you come to a conclusion of having a hedge ratio as 0.5. Clear, guys? Sorted. Wonderful. Now, in order to have a perfect hedge in your case, okay, the company need to short, I mean, the company need to sell how many times basically, okay, the existing position up, that is with 0.5 times. This is the hedge ratio. You need to short HR times, like hedge ratio times, to your existing position, because now the hedge ratio is basically telling you up that you are in a very safe zone. Your company is not very much riskier in comparison with the market. So you need to hedge only 50% of your portfolio in order to ensure that you hedge your position perfectly. So 0.5 multiplied by 10 metric ton, which comes out to be 5 metric ton of copper, multiply it with the spot price, which is 474. So 0.5 multiplied by 10 metric ton multiplied by 1000, which is 1 metric ton, multiply the same with 474, which is the price of per kg, and it comes out to be 2370,000. Clear, guys? Sorted with this particular question? It's a very simple one. All you need to have is a fair idea of calculating your hedge ratio, which I made you understand in this particular concept as itself. So just keep this thing in your mind. It is nothing but the kind of beta. Always and always remember, hedge ratio is going to be different for one company to another company depending upon the risk it is basically facing in comparison with other companies and in comparison with the overall market. So hedge ratio will be going on a very similar lines as to what beta will be. So this is nothing but beta, and it's basically defined the way I made you understand. Clear, guys? Sorted with this one? I hope now you guys are super confident about the kind of stuff that will be asked in CA final examination, and definitely you will just bang on once the examination question paper appears in front of you. I'm sure and I'm hopeful about this thing that you must have liked this video. If in case you have found this video informative, if in case you have liked this video, and if in case you know that this video is going to be really useful for your friends, then do share it with as many people as you can. Thank you on behalf of the ADPDR world. Stay connected, guys. I will see you up in my next presentation. Till then, God bless you all. Sayonara. Take care. Bye.